Well, greetings, Earthlings. I have energy today. I think from all this detoxing, I'm finally crawling out of the detox hole and feeling a little bit more energetic. So I'm going to make Hungry Hubby a pie. Okay, first the pie crust. 3 cups of flour and an eighth, can you see that? 1/8 of a teaspoon or less of salt. I use Himalayan salt. Culinary style. Okay, so here's how you sift your flour. If you're using a Cuisinart, you can certainly do it by hand. I did it by hand most of my life, but now my hand doesn't want to work. Whiz, 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 whiz. Okay, that's good. And then this is 1/2 cup of butter chunked up with 1/2 cup of shortening or lard chunked up, and I stick it in the freezer until it's pretty much frozen. So the shortening and lard, they don't get as hard as butter, but butter is flavor and the other stuff is for crispy, fluffy wonderfulness. Okay. Oh, all this. Then you put the lid on. My hands are slippery. Okay. Whiz. Coming out the top. Whiz. 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 This thing is so old. Flour's going everywhere. Not enough. They have to look like pea-sized. This is really my favorite pie crust for blind baking. And maybe for other baking. Oh yeah, we're getting there. 2 more pulses, we should be okay. Yep, okay. I'll be right back because I gotta wash my cruddy hands. Okie doke. In here I have a tablespoon, where are you? Tablespoon of lemon juice and 1 whole egg. And now I'm going to add 6 tablespoons of ice water. It was ice water anyway. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Well, you can use vinegar if you don't have a lemon, but it comes out just as nice. So now I've got the egg. 6 tablespoons of ice water. Whoops. Well, I dropped some of it, but just a little bit mixed and no pits. You don't want the lemon pits in there. Okay. So just sprinkle this or pour it right in. Ooh, nice and cold. A key to a pie crust that's super duper flaky is to make sure it's cold at all times. Okay. You want to just keep pulsing. Don't run it on the on cycle, just the pulse cycle. Or by hand, you're going to use a pastry cutter. The thing I always use when I make biscuits. Alright, that's what it should look like. See? Where are you? Okay, this will make 2 generous 9-inch or 10-inch pie shells. So if you're making like a deep dish apple pie, this will make a very generous topping because, you know, you're going to pile your apples up. But I'm not doing apples today. Okay. So let me clean my hands up and my space, and I'll show you how to take care of that. Just push it together into a disc. after about a half hour in the fridge. It will make rolling out the pie crust really nice and easy. Just keep it no chunky and just as smooth as you can. My arm's killing me today because I think it's going to rain. Alright, nice disc, and I've got one extra because I'm only making today a one crust pie, so that's going in the freezer. You can keep it in the freezer for a long time. Just keep it wrapped and stick it into a zip baggie. Where are you? You can use a quart size baggie. Works good. Okay, put it in your baggie. Write the date on it. I think this is the date. And you don't want to keep it more than 2 or 3 months in the freezer because it starts to turn a funny color. Anyway, that would be, use it, where are you? Use it sometime before November. Definitely. Okie doke. I keep this in a plastic bag in the fridge. It's a little small for the job. But, hey, my counters don't want to deal with anything else. Got some flour. I use all-purpose flour when I'm making my pie crust. Some people use pastry flour, but I don't. Look at those. Where are you? Look at those beautiful chunks of fat in there. Alright. So, this was in the fridge for about 2 and change hours. When you bang out a pie crust, it helps to keep its shape rather than rolling it. So I'm going to bang this out into sort of a circle because you know me, I have a crooked eye. Then we're going to cook it, bake it in the oven. But a tragedy has happened. I cannot find my pie beans. I've had them for like 30 years. I actually had 2 jars. I used the same old lentils over and over and over again for a million years. They won't cook. They're so dried out. But I gave Mom and Issa a jar because I had so much. Now I can't find them. I don't know where they are. All right, I'm going to bang this a little bit without you having to watch. Another phone call. Alright, that one was important. Okay, so now you've got this looking semi-normal. Start poking the bottom with a fork. And when you're done poking the bottom with a fork, poke it again and do the sides. Why? Shrinkage. Okay. So I put it in one direction, then the other. And the side. Okay, I'll keep poking. You don't have to. Okay, so it's pretty well poked and it's going back in the fridge while I preheat the oven to 400 degrees. Okay, we'll be back when the oven's hot. Put some foil in it. And then the beans. The good beans, not the pie beans. How can you lose 50,000-year-old beans? Great Northerns. I usually use lentils. Now I have new pie beans. I don't remember who it was, but I was telling somebody about pie beans and I got an urgent phone call. How do you get the beans unstuck from the pie crust? What? going to need a couple more minutes. Alrighty, so the pie crust is just barely browned on the edges. And the pie beans, if I ever find the other pie beans, I'll have millions of them. I can make 25 pies at a time. Dang, I broke the pie crust when I put it back in. But it won't matter. Not for this pie. I guess breaking the pie crust was really because I have to straddle the stupid tripod just so people won't ask me, did you ever hear of a tripod? Okie dokie. Now while you're baking, blind baking, fully baking, your pie crust, you must separate 4 cold eggs. Just whack it on a flat surface one time and hopefully everything comes out well. You don't want any yolk in the whites. Throw the whites. I did it backwards. So much for my dyslexia. You don't want to crack these on the edge of anything because they're surely going to break. Best egg separating tool comes with every human being, mostly. Four eggs. If you separate them while they're chilly, they do a better job of getting the whites all intact here. So, I have to switch the bowls around. And since you can't have any yolk in your meringue, I have to wash it. Okay, so the egg whites go in the mixing bowl. And you can let these come to room temperature while you're waiting for your pie shell to come out. Boy, I get so mad when I break a pie shell. So I mixed up the egg yolks. What is this? This is 1/2 cup measures of lemon juice. Barb had brought me about a bushel of lemons from a friend's orchard, so we juiced them and froze them in 1/2 cup servings so I could continue to make pies. The deal was that's where my other pie plates are. Barb has them. Anyway, had to make them for the guy who owned the orchard. One for Barb, one for Hungry, so I was in a pie baking mode. Okay. So 1 1/2 cups of sugar, 1 1/2 cups of water, and a pinch of salt coming to a boil. Now I have 1/3 cup of cold water. Well, it was cold when I poured it. And 1/2 cup. You know, I have a million measuring cups, but I only ever can find those stinking noisy ones. Okay, 1/2 cup. That's all I can use on sauce. 1/2 cup cornstarch. You only have to boil this just to the boil, and it's going to become a little clear, and then you're done. All right. Let me put this junk away, and I'll be back. Okay, so I'm gradually adding my cornstarch mix and my water, stirring constantly until it thickens. Oh, sorry, I had to bring the phone in here. I keep getting phone calls. All right, so you can feel it when it starts to go. So. Cook until it's nice and thick and clear. I remember when Barb brought up all those lemons, my arm was still in a sling. Okay. So she had to help me by stirring because I couldn't do half of it. Whoops, gotta check my pie shell. One more minute. Better to check it a couple of times. Okay, that's just about it. Off the heat. And I'll be back. Okay. No, I didn't put Tabasco sauce in here. But I can't move it because he loves it so much. Okay. Now, these are not thawed. I mean, this lemon juice is not thawed. But we can proceed anyway. Mix the lemon juice and the egg yolks. I should have just squeezed new ones, but these are nice lemon juices. So, just mix it up. It'll just make the filling cool down faster. Okay. Keep stirring it. Stir, stir, stir. Crazy stir. That's what Sweet Pea says. When her mother gave them a quiz, what does mommy do while you're sleeping? Sweet Pea says, clean crazy. And she does. Considering the abundance of children she has, she's an amazing wife and mother. And they're all little, too. I think Sweet Pea's 9. Let's see. How old is Sprout? 6 and a half. And then, Seedling is 3. And the baby is, that's the Weed Hopper. He's about almost 2. Well, 1 and a half. Okay, so it should look like that. It should be like that. And just let it sit on the back off heat. Okay, I'll be back. Want about a teaspoon of lemon rind or something like that. This really gives it lemon flavor. I think maybe as much as lemon juice does. So this lemon's a nice size, so should be about half of a lemon. But just eyeball it. And then 3 tablespoons of butter. Stir it in. You see? Stir it in. Then we're going to cover it and let it sit because it's got to cool down somewhat. While this is cooling to lukewarm, you can turn the oven off. But then after we put the meringue on, we're going to have to heat it up to 350. Whoops, that's not it. There we go. So, stir in the butter. I keep the butter in the freezer because it cools the filling down a lot faster. A lot of butter and eggs in this recipe. Okay, so let me get ready for the other part. That's as brown as I want it. See? I broke it. I broke it. Mmm. Flaky and delicious. Dang, it didn't turn on. Look, Junior. Alright. So I've got 1/4 teaspoon of salt and 4 egg whites, room temperature. And I'm going to whip them up. I started off on speed 1 and now I'm up to speed, I don't know, 6 maybe. And I'm adding 1/2 cup of sugar. And I'm going to beat them until stiff, glossy peeps again. Now I'm going to add this much meringue into the filling. A couple tablespoons. You can stir it in. You don't have to worry about it. Whether or not you're folding and so not to deflate. Who cares? Okay. This recipe works because you're going to use a hot filling in what is that? Some kind of funky little crumb was in there. So you want to put the hot filling into the pie shell, and then you want to put your meringue on top. We'll see if I can do this without dropping the pot in there. Okay. What do I want to do? I want to get this thing, not this thing. I know, I'm so discombobulated. We had a tragedy last week with one of our friends. It was heartbreaking. And we haven't felt like doing very much of anything. I can't talk about it. It was horrendous. But that's why I've been making weird videos lately. Okay. Broken pie shell. And then meringue on a hot filling. I know, it sounds weird, but that's how you do it. Uh-oh. Now your oven, remember, is 350. Anyway. I am not going to tell you what happened with that tragedy. Probably not ever. But pretty horrible. Need a spatula. If I can find it. Hungry emptied the dishwasher and filled the dishwasher a few hundred times because I didn't feel good. And I've been playing hide and seek forever. Okay, spatula. Go down to the edge of the pie crust. Yeah, try not to drag like I just did. First get that. You want the meringue to pretty much go to the crust. Whoops. You can fish out those little ugly things. Although you really won't see it when you do your meringue. Okay. This helps keep the filling from separating. And if you're using a nice warm filling, or even hot, your meringue will stay put. So I'm coming up in the danger zone where I broke the pie shell. This pie, in my opinion, would be best baked in a smaller pie shell, pie plate. I think it's a little bit too deep for this kind of pie, but since I couldn't find any pie shells, pie plates, meringue, and crumbs. Oop, I hear Bella again, barking her head off. Alright, this, if you're going to bake it in an 8 or a 9, this is a spectacular pie because it's so tall and fluffy. Alright. Okay, I'll be right back. I'm trying to scrape more meringue out of that bowl. Okay, throw it in the oven, 325, 15 minutes, check it, and maybe you'll go longer. And there's the broken pie crust. Oh, dang. He bought extra large eggs. Ugh, I need large. It's going to throw my recipe off a little.